killer T cells prevent foreign matters from entering the body and eliminate those that made it in. Here is a killer T cells white blood cell that has been stimulated. It stays in the bloodstream and goes around to greet other cells. If it finds them to be normal cells, it does nothing and moves on to others. But when it finds an abnormal cell, such as an infected cell, which shows an antigen on the surface of the abnormal cell membrane, the killer T cell makes contact with the abnormal cell and binds to its antigen. The killer T cell then sends signals to recruit other white blood cells to help deal with the infected cell. At the same time, the killer T cell releases perforin, shown here in pink, at the infected cell surface to generate pores in the infected cell. After creating a pore, the killer T cell releases granzymes, a type of cytotoxic protein, into the infected cell. The infected cell, which is also a protein, is destroyed, and the virus inside the infected cell, also a protein, is destroyed completely. This process truly kills the virus. In contrast to the other methods, like using antiviral drugs, that works only to suppress the virus from replicating. Therefore, immunotherapy produces a result that is different from that achieved by the use of antiviral drugs. The point here is important. You may recall that we mentioned earlier that we were able to stimulate Th17. Today, it is well known in the scientific community that Th17, which is a stem cell that has the ability to maintain genomic stability and the ability of self-renewal, can also directly eliminate infected cells. But for the most part, it is responsible for stimulating killer T cells, which, in turn, eliminate infected cells with high effectiveness. Both Th17 and the killer T cell that it stimulates are memory cells. Memory here refers to the fact that some cells have memory that they once dealt with the virus, and if that virus returns, our immune system will automatically destroy it. Therefore, the more we let killer T cells work, the more they become effective. Thus, the elimination of HIV virus is something that is definitely possible. So by effectively repairing damages on telomeres, we can reduce the side effects of antiviral drugs. And by efficiently stimulating killer T cells, we can kill and eliminate HIV virus.